The professor just now explained a method to share your messages secretly. So let me try to show you how can you share your messages in a secret way. Hello everyone, before we start doing the program for Substitution Cipher, I would like to explain a concept in Python named string. So first of all, what is a string? String is used to represent text in Python. Text may comprise of spaces, numbers, and even alphabets. So how can you use string here? For that, first of all, you need to import a library called string. Now I would take a variable named x and I would initialize it to a string. For example, it is hello world. Please note the fact that every time you initialize a string, you have to enclose the string in double quotes. So here we have the string called hello world. And if you want to access a particular alphabet in the string x, what we can do here is we can access the particular alphabet in string hello world by giving it a particular number. For example, if I want to access h in hello world, I would write print x of 0. As you know, the indexing starts from 0 in arrays as well as in strings. So if I want to access the alphabet h in hello world, that would start from 0. So h is at 0th position. So I would write print x of 0. So here we have h. And for example, if I want to access the alphabet O here, O has two occurrences. So if I want to access the alphabet O in the first position, that is, how can you do it? H is at 0th position, E is at 1st position, L is at 2nd, 2nd L is at 3rd position, and that O is at 4th position. Since O is at 4th position, I'll write X of 4, and now let us see what is the output. Here we have O. So this is how you can access the alphabets at particular position in a string. Okay. There are many other functions available in string. For example, if we want to access the alphabets from 2nd position to 5th position, how can you do that? You can actually do it in one go without even using for loop and any kind of loop. So I'll just say x of 2 colon 5 and I'll just print. So it prints LLO. This is how you can access the alphabets in a particular range of positions. Okay. Now if I want to get the length of the string, so for that you have a function. What you need to do is write len and then an len and in bracket write the name of the string. Here we have x, so we will write x. So let us print it. So it is 11. You can clearly see that the length of the string x is 11. Now if you want to convert the string x in uppercase, there is straight away a function available in Python. What we can do here is you just write the name of the string, that is x, and then dot, and then you have to write upper. Upper is a function available in Python used to convert the available string in uppercase. So now let us see what is the output. For that we should print it, print x dot upper. Yes, it converts the string, our string hello world, to uppercase. So we are done with strings now. There is one more function available in Python. In fact, there are many more functions, but here I would like to explain you one more. For example, in Hello World, if I want to replace one alphabet by some other alphabet, how can you do that? I'll just write x dot replace. For example, I want to replace H with J. So I'll just write replace H in double quotes, comma, then J in double quotes. So now the output is Jello World instead of Hello World. So this is about strings in Python. Now we will do the program for substitution cipher, and we'll use strings there.